Saurabh Maheshwari, and I welcome you all to the ongoing lecture series of C programming. And in the previous video, we covered what is a string and how we access various elements of a string, what is the difference between a character array and a string. So in this lecture video, we will see how to access a string with the help of various string functions. So the functions that we will cover is strlen, strcpy, strcat, and strcmp. We will cover these four functions. So when you want to calculate a length of a string, okay, so this is what we have to give input. We have to give input a character array. So this is a notation for character array. And when you give this character array input to the strlen function, so it returns the length of the string. Okay, length in the means is it returns the valid characters of the string, right? Valid characters of the string. We will see this with the help of a program just in few minutes. Okay, in strcpy, what happens is it stands for string copy function. So what happens, the first string is target and second is source. So this is target and this is source. So the contents of the source string is copied to the target string. Okay, so if you want to copy the content of one string to another, we use strcpy function. So now next function is strcat. This is concatenation. Concatenation is simply means if you want to join two strings together. Okay, suppose you have first string and you have second string, okay, and you want to join them together, so that in this can be done with the help of this particular function. Here the first string is this is first string and this is second string, and both of these strings are given input, and the output of the merging is in the first string. Okay, so there are some conditions that you have to follow that we will see in the program of strcat. Then strcmp is a function where two strings, the first string and the second string, are compared with each other. Okay, now what do you mean by comparison? Suppose this comparison is the comparison where which of the string comes before, okay, which of the string comes before in a dictionary. Okay, so this is one of the comparison of the strings. Let's say the apt, this is string, and this is string. Okay, so in dictionary you will find that both of these comes directly together. Okay, but as per the logic of strcmp, it compares on the basis of ASCII values. Okay, so A, it subtracts ASCII values of character by character. So it, when it does A minus A, it means it do 65 and 97. So this 97 is more than 65. So this is a negative result. Okay, so it means this will come after ACT. So capital ACT will come here as per the logic of strcmp in the dictionary. We will see it with the help of example also. Okay, so let us first start with the strlen. Okay, so here you can see strlen function use. Okay, we have taken one string, this is your input string, and I have left this empty. Okay, this is empty permissible only when you initialize. Okay, so we have initialized it with this. So can you guess what is the byte size of or what is the element size of ch? So you have to count the characters. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 7 are the characters, and 8 character would be null character, right? So this ch, value of ch is equivalent to writing this ch 8. Okay, ch 7 would not be correct answer, because there are 7 valid characters and one character is required for that particular null character. So total 8 character spaces required. Okay, I have taken one integer element len to store the length. So if you write name of character in the strlen argument, okay, so this is called argument of a function. So function name is strlen, and we are putting parameter or argument. The name is parameter or argument. So character array, and specifically it has to be a string array. Okay, so string when given input in strlen function, it returns the number of valid characters. So can you guess what this len will be? What this len will return? This len will return only the valid characters. The length of the ch is okay, sir. The length of the number of elements. The number of elements in ch is 8, but length of the ch is 7 only, because it has valid 7 characters. So this len will print 7. Fine. So I have also shown a comparison between size of ch. Size of ch is this function gives you the byte size of variable. Fine. So there are 7 valid characters. Strlen function gives only the valid characters. Strlen function gives the valid characters, right? Excluding null character. Okay, null character, right? And a size of function when applied on ch, it gives byte size of variable, right? So byte size of variable is 8 here. So the size of ch output is 8, whereas length of string Saurabh, this is printed using this %s. So the length of string is %d, and %d is len, and which is 7. So this is how strlen function works. You can calculate anywhere the length of the string through this function. Okay. Now next function that we will look over is strcpy. Okay. This is the second function that we will look. It stands for string copy. Fine. And why this string copy is done? It is simply to suppose we have content in one of the string, and we want to create a copy of this string to another string, another character array. So we use strcpy. So the first argument, the first parameter here, there are two arguments. How many arguments are there? There are two arguments or two parameters. Right, in the strlen there was only one argument, fine, that was single string whose length was to be calculated. But for copying, we required a target and we require a source. So source would be the string which is to be copied. Okay, and target is copy destination. Fine. So where you want to keep the copy is the second variable. Fine. First variable. Okay. So first you have to give target, and second you give the source. So this is why how strcpy works. So first string is %s. We have written ch1, and you can see it is copied to the string %s ch2. You can see the answer of ch1 is this, and answer of ch2 is this. So this is ch1, which was originally given, and this is ch2. So ch2 was initially not given any value, and when you try to print it, so you will get that the same value of ch1 is copied to ch2. So both ch1 and ch2, this is important thing to remember, both target and source has same values. Has same values. Fine. Okay. Now let us see another function, that is strcat, that is string concatenation. String okay. So concatenation is a word to join. Okay, it is simply a synonym of join. Suppose I have one string one, as suppose I have a b c d, and I have string two as another string as e f g h. Okay, and you want a string that is a b c d e f g h, which is a concatenation of a or concatenation of b after a. Okay, so how you will do this happens with the help of getting first as input. Okay, here we are taking input from user. In the previous programs we directly declared in the initialization the string, but here we are taking from the user. So here we will write put as, this will print the instruction for the user on the string to enter the first string. Here you can see this, and suppose user enters this string. Okay, user enters this string. So this is taken from get as function and is stored in ch1. So now ch1 has this particular string. Okay, so how I will write it as a u r a b h. Okay, and after that all the remaining elements, because you can see the size of this is 30. Okay, ch1 is 30, so remaining all elements are backslash 0, that is null characters. Okay, if one is null character, all the remaining are null character. Okay, because if any one is initialized, all remaining are initialized with the initial value. So that is the concept of array. Okay, now you can see instead of putS, now we are taking as an option of printf, right? So here you can also take first string is %s. So for formatting output, you have to use printf only, because this functionality is not available. In putS, you can directly write a single string, but these format specifiers works only with the printf statement. Okay, so that is why we are used here printf. So the thing that has been input here is first string is Saurabh. So this string has been printed over here. Okay, now we again print putS, enter the second string. You can also see putS after printing putS change line automatically, right? So there is backslash n in the end directly. So you can see here, enter the second string and change line is automatically running here, right? So there is a change line is automatically running here. So that is logic of putS. Now user inputs a string, that is the second name of the user, suppose it is. So it is input in the ch2. So this becomes your ch1 and this becomes your ch2. Okay, now what I want, we want that this ch1 and ch2 should be concatenated with each other, and we want that ch1 plus ch2. So what I want, it happens like that, ch1 and ch2. So ch2 should be concatenated after ch1. So what is the order you have to follow? You have to follow first ch1 and then ch2, because order we want that ch1 should be first. So that is, you will write this first string and then ch2 will be concatenated. So there would be no space, right? So the as it is, what the elements you have entered in the second string will get concatenated, and the value of ch1 will be updated like this. Okay, so this is value of ch1. I have written ch3, that is only to show that there is no requirement of a new array. Okay, the result will be stored in the first element. Okay, so this is your target, this is your source, and the result is target plus t plus s. Okay, and plus plus you mean by, I mean by concatenation. Okay, so what you have to just keep in mind that ch1 should have or must have the space available for the t plus s. Okay, it must have. Suppose we won't have 20 characters and the space is for 30 characters for ch1, so we cannot give more than 10 characters. Okay, 10 characters in CH1 at a time during the input. So what I would suggest to take CH1 big enough to hold the values combined with CH1 and CH2, like we did in the merging. Okay, in the merging of sorted arrays, what we did, the merged array must have the length of elements together of the sum of the both arrays. Okay, here as the result would go in CH1 only, so CH1 should have a minimum space of CH1 plus CH2. Okay, the valid number of characters, not counting these null characters, only the valid characters, right? Okay, so this is how we perform second string is this, and then we printed the concatenated string, which is with the help of putS we have done it. So for printing any variable, any string variable using putS, this is the syntax for using putS.